I'm going to talk to you about Goblet, but also I mentioned earlier that I have an Elixir hat. And so I'm also going to be saying things about Elixir and about the text. I hope you will provide some kind of introduction to some of the things that Niall will talk about. Okay, so I'll briefly say something about where Goblet came from, who we are, why we are, and some of the things about what we do, and of course why we're here. So the first question is, where did Goblet come from? So we are the global organisation for bioinformatics, learning, education and training. So I thought the easiest thing to try to describe to you where we came from was to look back in time to some of the earliest developments through Elixir. So back in the midst of time, end of 2000 through to 2012 was the Elixir preparatory phase. And part of the preparatory phase involved training components. So they formed a strategic committee on training who were tasked to provide advice on Elixir's training strategy once it went into its implementation phase. So I was invited to be part of that training strategy committee, and we were asked to formulate a report and make recommendations by around mid-June 2009. And so amongst those, we're not tracking very well here, are we? So amongst some of those recommendations that we made, there were several of them, but I've distilled out a few that are, I think, relevant here. So the first was that there needed to be some kind of central registry, both for trainers to share expertise and materials, and for trainees to be able to find suitable courses. One of the recommendations was to develop benchmarking and evaluation systems. Another was to facilitate development of new training programs and integration with existing initiatives. And finally, to provide a forum for interaction with other European training infrastructures, of which there were many. So those are the core things that came out of the report. Now, during this preparatory phase, more or less coinciding with the formulation of our recommendations, the EBI was awarded another grant, and this was called SLIG. So I think it's Serving Life Science Information for the Next Generation, something like that. And SLIG clearly built directly on some of the outcomes of the preparatory phase of Elixir, and it had a significant training component. Out of that training component came something very important, because that was what became the core of what Goblet became. And this was something called the Bioinformatics Training Network. So the Bioinformatics Training Network essentially came out of training meetings hosted by SLIG. And again, two of the major outcomes of the Bioinformatics Training Network were essentially this network of people, this forum of interaction amongst not just European trainers, but global trainers, and the idea that they wanted to build a training registry. And in fact, that's what they did. So the Bioinformatics Training Network, the BTN, formed the original training materials repository. So those were two main outcomes of SLIG. Now the problem was, having created this very, very active network, the network came out of project funding, and the project had a finishing date, and that finishing date was August 2012. So something else I wanted to say about the BTN, one of the key things about it is there's a very, very active group of trainers passionate about what they did. We had an annual meeting, usually in November, and I want to come back to something you said earlier, Jack, which was, we often come to meetings like this, and we sit around and we chat and have presentations, yada, 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 then we all go home again and nothing ever happens. The thing about the BTN was, we talked and then did stuff. And we wrote papers. So it was a very active, very productive group of people. Anyway, so it was delineated by the fact that the project grant, the grant funding came to an end, and we wanted to make it continue. The other slight sort of political social aspect about it was that this was a grant to CBI. So although this was a kind of international training network, the website itself was hosted by the EBI. And what we wanted to do was take it out of the EBI to make it everyone's, and to allow this network of people to continue to work together. So it was at that point that, with a different hat on, my hat then was the chair of EMBNet. I brought together 9 other organisations. We got together and said, well, is there any value in creating an umbrella organisation, bringing together everything that we all do in the realms of training, to create some kind of structure that will allow us to continue doing what we do, but in a sustainable way? And that was the birth of Goblet. So we had our first meeting in November to coincide with what would have been the next BTN meeting. So we handed over from BTN to Goblet through that process. So inevitably, because we came out of this Elixir route, there are overlaps with the recommendations from the preparatory phase. So of course, these two were clear from the start because we came from BTN, but also we wanted to become involved with benchmarking and explore evaluation systems, and we also wanted to get involved with delivering training and interacting with other organisations delivering training. So a few months later, Elixir went into its implementation phase. It's kind of tricky to say when it started. I kind of link it to the hiring of the new director. So that was Nicholas Blombeau in around February, March 2013. So that's when the implementation phase sort of started, and then lots of European countries then made proposals to become known as Elixir. Amongst those, of course, was the UK. The UK bid to become a name and was funded by the BBSRC. I'll spare you the politics of it, but for various reasons, the UK became a training node of Elixir. And part of its mandate was to build a training platform, which was time-based tests. So by now, it's clear that we've got two things running in parallel that have very similar objectives. So we've got Elixir UK building tests as part of Elixir, and we've got Goblet up and running that's also got a training portal. So it's very, very clear that from an early stage we needed to build bridges to have dialogue so that we weren't competitive, but we would actually work together. So in April 2015, we signed an agreement to work together in certain areas. So we formed a joint Goblet Elixir training strategy, and the four key areas were defined as training portals. Obviously, we wanted those to be synergistic. Train the trainer and train the research activities. To explore accreditation mechanisms, and I use the word advisedly, explore, because accreditation is a huge thing, as I'm sure you know. We can talk about that later. And also to share best practices, to professionalise bioinformatics training, really to up the quality of bioinformatics training provision. Last thing I want to say about this on this slide is that Elixir UK funding for the test pilot finished, but the work continued through another grant, which was Accelerate, and this allowed us to allow Mile to continue with the development of tests. And you can't see it there, it's on the ceiling, but test production. First version was released sometime last year. Okay, so that's completed history of where Goblet came from. But to try to try to explain really the relationship, the very close relationship and synergistic relationships between Goblet and Elixir. So who we are, we're a network of 30 organisations. These include international and national networks and societies, research groups, small companies and so on, plus individual members, and that includes students. So we registered as a Dutch foundation in November 2012, and our work is orchestrated by a small executive team, of which we have a member sitting with us, Annette, and also we have an operational board that includes the chairs of our five committees. Sonica will be the acting chair of the standards committee, if not already, then in the very near future. So just to show that, but anyway, this makes the same point that we have an executive and operational board that orchestrates the activities, and our general assembly includes all of these people, all of the organisations, all of the students and individual members who form the voting college. So why did we come about? Hopefully I'll just make that fairly obvious, because we all share interests in mathematics education and training. We all have similar missions and similar challenges. But by coming together as Goblet, we can participate in and influence initiatives otherwise wouldn't happen. We can address problems on an international scale. We can work towards common solutions, and we hope a sustainable future by sharing, not duplicating effort, and sharing, not duplicating cost. So our vision is to unite, inspire, and equip mathematics trainers worldwide, with a mission to cultivate the global mathematics training community, to set standards and provide high quality resources to support learning, education and training. So one of the first things we did was build our website, which includes a training portal. The training portal includes a catalogue of trainers and organisers, and also a repository of courses and materials. I would say one thing about this: we recently hired a technical intern, and he's tasked to completely revamp our pages, because we have huge branding issues. Hopefully we'll see a much nicer resource in the near future. So in terms of standards, you've already heard about our schemas. We worked with the original group, Kim Birmingham, whenever that was, a long time ago. So we try to work closely with Elixir, we've also tried to join forces with other standards initiatives, and in fact we had a special education and training session in the NetApp workshop last October, which brought together representatives from Goblet, Elixir and the CHARM Cost Action, amongst others, to talk about standards and standard operating procedures in mathematics, and with particular emphasis here on training. And I'll say a little bit more about CHARM later on. Obviously all of this is intended to help us work towards fair training. No point be dwelling on this slide, because I think we'll agree that this is the direction we want to go in. So I'll move quickly on. I mentioned that we share best practices. We do this through workshops and publishing what we do. So in 2014, we held a special session for high school teachers in Toronto, so trying to train high school teachers in best practices for mathematics training for high school teachers. We had a train-the-trainer session in South Africa in 2015, and another train-the-trainer best practices in mathematics training in Brisbane last November, in association with the Australian Mathematics and Computational Biology Society. Again, I mentioned publications. And we share materials, but also best practices in annotating materials. So there was an Elixir Goblet hackathon for annotating metagenomics training materials last year. And this week there's another one, this time it's an Elixir Goblet Galaxy Training Network hackathon for Galaxy Training Material Reuse. So there's a lot of joint activities, a lot of activities area. So one of the other things that we've done is run a number of surveys. It's all very well talking about training, but if you don't know what your community needs in terms of training, then you know, you're just a talking shop. So we ran community surveys to assess skill gaps. One of the first we did was with the Society for Experimental Biology. I won't read through this entire slide, but some of the key points are that three quarters of the respondents said that they considered themselves to be self-taught in bioinformatics. Two-thirds of them wanted extra training in data analysis and interpretation. And another three quarters said that they would prefer to receive their training through workshops, and just over 50% through e-learning modules. We also worked with the biocuration community and ran a special education and training session at the biocuration conference. Really to try to find out what biocurators wanted in the way of training as well. So one of the things I didn't say earlier on was when we first talked about setting up the Goblet, so the acronym uses bioinformatics explicitly. Actually, what we wanted to do was bring together people interested in bioinformatics, biocuration, biotechnology, computational biology, so we're not restricted, and data science probably comes into all of that as well. We also do some hands-on training. I pick out just a couple here. So one was an MLABR workshop on RNA-seq data analysis, and another one jointly with Abacus, and many others. And we're also going into a phase now where we're wanting to try to provide high-quality resources, going back to the quality thing. So these will be manually created, bespoke resources, working closely with MNET and Elixir. So these would include things like quick guides and critical guides for bioinformatics, structured resources to support the Elixir Goblet Trainer program. Again, also materials to support high school teachers to bring bioinformatics into the classroom. And working on developing workflows on different topics for different audiences, and potentially, you know, I will say something about that later on. It's a bit of a mystery what Niall's going to talk about, given the loss of his laptop. So we also try to promote our work and what we do. So we write papers. Won't bore you with all of those, but just to highlight this most recent, it's not a new paper, but we're pleased to get a correspondence piece in Nature. We also publicise our work through our member newsletters. We get a lot of support in that, which is nice. And we've also got our own newsletter, which we managed to kick off last year. Again, we've got a huge branding issue, and hopefully that will be sorted out in the near future. We've also worked very closely, we're trying to work closely with our members. In particular, we work closely with the ISCB, the International Society for Computational Biology. And one of the first things we did with them was to establish for the first time an education poster track for the ISMB conference. We also worked with them to run another high school teacher workshop that was in Boston in 2014. And together with them, we launched the Computational Biology Education Community of Special Interest. So that really is a meeting of Goblet and the ISCB Education Committee. So there are many different COSIs, as they're called, and the COBE COSI is the one that we're trying to get off the ground. But the importance of this is that it's bringing education and training into the mainstream of that conference, which primarily had been about research. So what else we do? We eat our own dog meat. So having set up this poster track, then we've been very eager to submit posters. either as the consortium as a whole or through our committees. We also seek funds to support some of our activities, so we've had a number of small-scale grants from Canada, South Africa and Australia to support our annual general meetings. We have worked with the CoData RDA to get funding to support the Data Science Summer School, and this is an organisation that probably you should be talking to if you're not already. And we partnered with an EU cost action, which is called CHARM, which is coordinated by Suzanne Holman. So CHARM stands for Harmonising Standardisation Strategies to Increase Efficiency and Competitiveness of European Life Science Research. Not contrived at all. But anyway, it's important for us to be involved in these kind of standards. Moving swiftly on, yes. They need some education on coming up with great acronyms. So, overall then, GOLBET helps to coordinate global bioinformatics training activities, to promote and deliver bioinformatics training worldwide, to disseminate best practices, to provide fora for discussing training issues, and to help survey and address the training needs of life scientists. So why we're here, we're here because we're interested in building bridges like the ones we've already created with Elixir and with CHARM and with CoData. I also just threw in this here, which you may or may not be aware of, which is the GoFair overarching initiative that has within it three different platforms, one of which is called GoTrain. And GoTrain at the moment are in the process of articulating an implementation network. And that might be something because they're now just beginning to articulate that. That might be a thing that you want to get involved with. So we're also interested in sharing content, resources, and so on. We're interested in developing training metadata standards, workflows, and so on. And of course, that's what this workshop is all about. So this is a great opportunity to create synergies and help shape the future together, not just with all the people that we usually do it with, but also with the BDCK training communities. And that's it. I have no picture of the view from my office, but I have a picture of myself.
Thank you. Very nice. Thank you, Tim. Time for one or two quick questions? Okay, we'll save them up. Again, write them down on a little sticky note and save them for our discussion. Oh, Dr. Burns.
So what is your vision, if any, for the application of AI within GOLBET? So clearly that's what we do. That's what we're interested in. Have you thought about how that language speech recognition can be applied to the kind of material that you're interested in?
It's not something we've done.